So imagine you come into the office on a Monday morning and you grab yourself a coffee, sit down at your desk, and your automated custom-built Google Ads AI analyst has sent you directly to your Slack the perfect summary about how your Google Ads campaigns performed last week and notified you to any significant changes that have happened and maybe alerting you to any actions you need to take. No more spending the first half an hour digging through Google Ads reports. It's being sent directly to you on a Monday morning, automated, and you can even forward it directly onto your manager so they also know how the campaigns are performing. We're going to show you exactly how to build it using make.com. And before we go into a step-by-step tutorial, let's just see how it works. So I'm going to run this once. And we can see this has run now and it's being sent to Slack. What's actually happening here? So we're running two different Google Ads reports. We'll see why a bit later on. And then we're using Anthropic's Claude to basically do our AI analysis and sending that to Slack. Let's have a look at the Slack message that came through. Here we go. Weekly analysis. These are the significant campaign changes. You can see here for our sunglasses campaign, saw significant growth across all metrics. However, the cost increased outpaced the click increase, indicating a higher CPC. Dramatic increases across all metrics indicate a possible expansion of this campaign or a significant shift. So pretty cool. So we have campaign per campaign, all the important changes that we need to be alerted. And then we also have an overall weekly summary to see how we're doing. Now, over on our website, we have the full tutorial guided step-by-step so you can follow along and build this AI analyst for yourself. We include all the prompts that we use, also how to set up the Google custom report query that you can just easily copy and paste over. So head over to our website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you can also follow along and build this yourself. All right, let's now build this out step by step. I'm going to show you exactly how easy it is to set this up in Make, set up your automated Google Ads AI analyst. Now, if you don't have a Make account yet and you need to sign up for the first time, we have a special link that you can use and you basically will get 1 month on the pro plan for free. You don't need to enter a credit card. Your first month will be completely free on the pro plan and you get to use 10,000 operations. So more than enough to test out the platform and build your first AI automations. So in order to get that link, what you need to do is check the description below, open up the tutorial guide on our website. And at the top of the tutorial, there's the link there that you can use and create your Make account with that free first month on the pro plan. But for anyone else, let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is add my Google Ads Reports module. So I'm just searching it here from the list of apps, Google Ads Reports, and I want to run a custom report. So my connection is already set up. For anyone who's doing this for the first time, again, in that tutorial, you have all the instructions on how you can actually create your connection and select your account ID. We're using a variable here to hide the, like, let's say, sensitive information. But what's really important here is setting up your query. First of all, I'm also going to change the limit to 1,000. If you have more than 1,000 campaigns, probably getting tough. And in the fully guided tutorial, I'm going to grab this query now. So here we've got prepared for you that first query that you can paste in. Right now we're using a fixed date, but we'll show you at the end how we can make this dynamic. So I'm copying this one, going over to Make and dropping this in the query. And I just need to get rid of this copy word. We'll definitely fix that. And hit OK. And now we can basically test this out. I'm going to run this module and we see we're getting our results here. What we will then do now is, as I mentioned, we need to aggregate this to CSV. So I'm going to add another module and search for the CSV, and I'm going to create a CSV advanced. And so what that one does, it basically enables you to determine what type of data structure you would like. So what are going to be your column headers of your CSV? We've also given you a quick way to set this up. So you're just going to add a new data structure, and let's call this one here, Demo Google Ads AI Analyst. And of course you could individually go through and set up all your column headers, but we like doing things a little bit faster here at 9X. So I'm going to hit generate. And again, we're going to head over to our tutorial. And here we've given you the structure of the CSV that you can just go ahead and copy. And I'm going to go over here, paste this. This is in what's known as a JSON, a JavaScript object notation. And you can think of it just as another way of representing data in a table where we have different key and value pairs. I'm going to hit generate. And now you can see automatically all of my column headers, campaign name, metrics, clicks, conversions, cost, impressions, and the week have all been generated for me. I can hit save and these appear now here, and these I can map into from this first module. So I'm just going to do that mapping quickly and then we'll skip ahead. So here, what I've done is I've grabbed every single like line item that we're getting about our campaigns from the first bundle. So what campaign name is it? What clicks, what conversions, what costs, what impressions, and what week? And mapping them into the CSV module. And then what this is going to do is aggregate this all into one CSV and give a row for each campaign. So again, we can test this out. I'm going to actually now click run once. It's going to give you a little warning, but we can run anyway. And now we should see, if I have a look, we've got all the bundles, 29 bundles going in and that one long text string going out. Perfect. What we need to do now is basically duplicate both of these. There's a really quick way to do this in Make. You can hold down Shift on your keyboard and draw like a little rectangle over those two modules. I'm going to hit Command C. You can also here copy modules and then paste them in. I'll allow Make to do whatever it wants. We can hit this little align button to make it look nice again. And now the only thing what we need to do is go into this, let's say, second Google Ads report module. And I'm just going to change the date to be 1 week later. So theoretically, this should be the date of last week. And the first module will be the date of 2 weeks ago. For the sake of this demo, I'm using fixed dates for now. And what we can do now is add in our Anthropic module and run Claude. So here I'm going to search for Anthropic. And you can see it's only got one option, which is create a prompt. So I've already set up my Claude connection. For those of you that have not done this yet or set up your Anthropic connection, you can go here to console.anthropic.com, sign up. This is a paid service, but then you can just get your API keys. And I'm going to create a new key and I'll call this one GAds demo key. Select the workspace. In our case, it's just default. Hit add, and here it's going to give you that API key that you need to copy over and set up your connection. But in our case, it's good to go. So we can actually just already set this prompt up. So I'm going to change the maximum tokens used to 8,000 because it is a bit of data that it is processing. And now I want to add a message. And you can think of this as, what is the prompt that I want to send to Claude, to the LLM? And so the role is, my role is user. The user is sending a message here. And what am I sending? I'm sending text. And the text is basically going to be my prompt. And let's go over and copy that from the tutorial. Okay, so this is the long prompt that we have here. I can just talk a little bit about it. So what it's doing is it's using what are known as delimiters to say, hey, here's the data from 2 weeks ago. And here we're going to paste in the results of the CSV. Here's the data from last week. Whenever you're like, especially when you're using AI and automations, using these delimiters is a very good trick because it really helps the LLM understand, hey, here's the start of something and here's the end. Because sometimes you might have dynamically putting in a long string that includes word like the end or finish, but having these delimiters makes it really easy to say, ah, this is the data from 2 weeks ago and this is the data from last week. And now we're giving it some very specific prompts, telling it in what case is it a significant change. So for instance, here is if a percentage has changed more than 10%, either positive or negative, this is something you should alert us about. Feel free to go and play around with this prompt, edit it, make it exactly right for your use case, but this is already giving pretty good results from us. So we can just copy this one and I'm gonna go over to Make and I'm gonna press Command Shift V so that we keep that formatting, but you can just paste it in, it shouldn't matter. Again, we'll remove this annoying copy word at the top. And now what we're going to do is replace these default placeholders with the results of the CSV. So I know the data from 2 weeks ago was from my first CSV module with the number 2 here. So I'm just going to hit that one. And then the last week's data is from the second CSV module and hit OK. Let's now try and run this just to make sure this step is working. The Claude step can take a little bit of time. We're fast forwarding it in this demo. All right, so that analysis is run. The LLM has given us a result. So let's take a look. We can see here a few different options that we get as the output of this Claude prompt. So one very cool thing to check out is sometimes the usage. You can see we had here almost 2,500 tokens coming in and 2,000 tokens coming out. Tokens is basically the way that the LLMs will also calculate your pricing. So sometimes it's important to take a look at this. And so you have tokens in is basically how long is your prompt, and tokens out is how long is the response. And then here in the text response, we can see our analysis has basically been done. And we can see that here, very nice. And so the last thing that's left is basically sending this to you to Slack. So let's go ahead and add a Slack module. I'm just going to select Slack from the list of options, click here on show more, and I want to create a message. Again, our connection is already set up, so creating your Slack account should be pretty easy. Again, in the tutorial, we've got exact instructions on how to do that. If, for instance, you're not using Slack at your organization, this could be an email here. You could send it to Teams if you're using Microsoft Teams. Whichever Slack, let's say, communication form is the best for you, you can feel free to use that. The one thing you might need to do is slightly adjust the output of the prompt, because I've also in the prompt included how it should be formatted for Slack. So just keep an eye on that one. Now I'm going to just select which channel this should be sent to. I'm going to select it from a list. In our case, it's a public channel and it's going to be log ads performance. And here now is the text that we can put in. So I'm just going to drop this text response. You could also feel free to include more text above, like a little header like we did in the demo that says, hey, this is the weekly analysis. But now I'm just going to simply drop in the text response here. So now we're pretty much done here. The only thing is, as I mentioned, that right now these dates are hard coded, are fixed. We can basically change this now by making the dates that are listed here in our reports dynamic. And we've given you those formulas also in the tutorial. So let's grab them now. So here we are. Let me copy this one. And so this is actually the one from last week. So I'll go and do this one first. And what I'll do is I'll paste this in and I'll show you what it's doing. So in Make, you have some different functions up here. So you have, for instance, functions to manipulate numbers, to manipulate text, and also functions to manipulate dates. And what we're doing here is we're doing using the format date function, which will basically take a dynamic date and put it into a text format. And in our case, we're putting it into the format that Google Ads needs it, which is year first, then month, then day. And what we're doing is we're taking the what is the exact day now, and we're minusing 7 days from it. So we're using the add days function, but actually subtracting days. So what's important, this one, as I said at the start, will only work if this report runs on a Monday. So I'll show you how to schedule that like that in a second. But just so you know, is basically whenever this will run, this will say, hey, what is 7 days ago? And format it into the format that it needs. I'm going to copy this one over, just get rid of this copy text, and go into my first Google Ads module, and then change this one to 14 days. So now dynamically, we're getting the data from 2 weeks ago, and we're getting the data from last week. To finish this off, all we need to do now is go into the scheduling settings at the bottom here. Right now, by default, it would run every 15 minutes. I think this would be a little bit of an overkill. So definitely make sure you adjust this scheduling before you turn the scenario on. I want this to run days of the week, specific days of the week, in my case, on a Monday. And let's say we're early birds here at 9X. So I'm gonna change this to 7:35. So I know I'm coming in the morning, I'm grabbing my coffee, and this Google Ads report is already on its way to my Slack. I can hit OK, save this, and then all I need to do is schedule this one on, and your Google Ads AI analyst is now automated and will go to work. Now, if you enjoyed this tutorial, definitely remember to like the video and subscribe to the 9X YouTube channel. We're going to be releasing many AI and automation tutorials on a regular basis, so always be informed when the next video drops.